What is heart failure? Heart failure means that the heart's pumping power is weaker than normal. With heart failure, blood moves through the heart at a slower rate, and the pressure in the heart increases. Therefore, the heart becomes congested. As the result, the heart cannot pump enough oxygen to meet the body's demand. We can divide the heart failure into the left-sided heart failure, which includes the left atrium and the left ventricle, or the right-sided heart failure, which includes the right atrium and the right ventricle. Now, heart failure can be either due to systolic dysfunction, which is the inability for the heart to contract and push out the blood, or diastolic dysfunction, which is the inability for the heart to relax. So here are some of the risk factors for congestive heart failure. CAD, in which the major blood vessels that supply the heart muscles with blood and oxygen become narrowed or diseased, leading to damage to the heart muscles. Myocardial infarction or heart attack, which is the death of the heart muscles due to an ischemic event. Cigarette smoking. Hypertension, which leads to left ventricular hypertrophy, which makes it harder to oxygenate the heart muscles and can eventually lead to ischemic damage to the heart muscles. Obesity and diabetes, which can both lead to CAD. Heart valve disease, such as aortic stenosis, which can eventually lead to left ventricular hypertrophy and ischemic changes, similar to hypertension. Cardiomyopathy, which is another name for heart muscle disease. For example, dilated cardiomyopathy, in which heart's ability to pump blood is decreased because the heart's main pumping chamber, the left ventricle, is enlarged and is associated with alcohol and viral infection. Hypertrophic cardiomyopathy, which is associated with thickening of the heart muscle, most commonly at the septum between the right and the left ventricle. Restrictive cardiomyopathy, which is a condition in which the walls of the heart are abnormally rigid and lack flexibility to expand as the ventricle fills with blood, and it's associated with amyloidosis and sarcoidosis and fibrosis. Even though both the left and the right-sided heart failure pretty much have the same clinical features, the left-sided heart failure presents with symptoms associated with pulmonary edema, which is due to failure of the left ventricle to sufficiently remove blood from the pulmonary circulation. This leads to fluid accumulation in the lungs, and the clinical features such as dyspnea or shortness of breath, paroxysmal nocturnal dyspnea, which is the sudden worsening of dyspnea at night during sleep, and orthopnea, which is shortness of breath that occurs when laying flat and improves when sitting up and standing. And also, since the heart is not pumping out enough blood, there is going to be decreased forward perfusion. This leads to activation of renin-angiotensin aldosterone system, which causes fluid retention and worsens the symptoms of congestive heart failure. The most common cause of right-sided heart failure is actually the left-sided heart failure, and the common clinical features include dyspnea, since the right heart is unable to pump blood into the lungs to get oxygenated, jugular venous distension, since the jugular veins cannot empty their blood into the congested right atrium, pitting edema, which is due to fluid overload and increased hydrostatic pressure, ascites, which is due to fluid accumulation in the peritoneal cavity, nutmeg liver, which is due to chronic passive congestion of the liver, and as you can see here, it resembles a cut nutmeg. In order to diagnose congestive heart failure, we can use echocardiogram, which distinguishes systolic from diastolic dysfunction by measuring the ejection fraction. It can also determine if an acute myocardial ischemia is causing heart failure by showing abnormal wall motions, as well as identifying any valve diseases. We can also measure B-type natriuretic peptides, or BNP, which are secreted by the ventricles of the heart in response to excessive stretching of the heart muscle cells. And it can be also used to differentiate between causes of dyspnea due to heart failure from other causes of dyspnea. We can also use chest x-rays, which can show us cardiomegaly, which is enlargement of the heart. EKG can be also used to identify any arrhythmias, ischemic heart diseases, right and left ventricular hypertrophy, and conductive delay or abnormalities, such as left bundle branch block. In order to properly treat congestive heart failure, we must first focus on modifying the patient's lifestyle by encouraging the patient to lose weight, stop smoking, exercising, limiting their alcohol intake, and having a healthier diet, which are all equally effective in preventing diastolic and systolic heart failure. The pharmacological management for systolic dysfunction heart failure includes ACE inhibitors and/or angiotensin receptor blockers, beta blockers, spironolactone, diuretics, and if nothing else works, we can give them the digoxin. Medical therapies for diastolic dysfunction heart failure are not as well defined as therapies for systolic heart failure. Some of the medications that are used include beta blockers, calcium channel blockers, ACE inhibitors, and diuretics. Please support us by pressing the subscribe button and by sharing this video on your favorite social media website. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them in the comment section below. For more videos, please visit our website at www.medical-institution.com. Thank you and good luck.